Introduction to Xylazine. The information presented in this video is not intended to provide or replace professional medical advice, medical care, or overdose response training. Welcome to this microlearning on xylazine. In just a few minutes, you'll learn what xylazine is, how it affects the body, what drugs it's found in, how to respond to overdose, and how to care for xylazine-related wounds. Let's begin with a closer look at what xylazine is and why it's showing up in the drug supply. Xylazine is a drug that is being added to the illicit drug supply in the United States. Xylazine is a non-opioid veterinary tranquilizer that is not approved for use in humans. It is often referred to as tranq or tranq dope. Xylazine was first used as an additive to heroin in Puerto Rico in the early 2000s, and from there spread to Philadelphia around 2017. While still concentrated in the Northeast, xylazine is now being detected across the entire United States. Xylazine can be added to drugs that are injected, snorted, smoked, or swallowed. Now that we know what xylazine is, let's explore how it affects the body and why these effects are causing serious concern for public health. Xylazine can cause profound sedation that can last for several hours. Sedation is a state of relaxation and sleepiness that can result in the inability to respond. While sedation is the most common effect of xylazine, it can also cause decreased blood pressure and decreased heart rate. The sedation caused by xylazine can also result in nerve and muscle injuries from staying in the same position for extended periods of time while sedated. Xylazine can create dependence, and people who use it regularly, whether intentionally or not, can experience withdrawal symptoms if they discontinue use. Withdrawal symptoms can include anxiety, agitation, increased blood pressure, and increased heart rate. Withdrawal symptoms can last for days to weeks, with the worst symptoms usually occurring in the first few days after stopping use. Sometimes medical help is needed to manage withdrawal. Xylazine has also been associated with the development of wounds, most typically on the forearms and lower legs, though they can occur in other places too. The wounds can be significant, cover large areas of skin, and look a bit like severe burns. Wounds can develop from any type of xylazine use, injecting, smoking, or snorting, and they do not necessarily develop in the same places where people are injecting drugs. Xylazine isn't a drug people usually seek out, but it's ending up in more and more substances. In this next section, we'll talk about which drugs xylazine is commonly found in and how people can check for its presence. Xylazine is most often added to heroin and fentanyl, usually without the knowledge of those who are buying and using the drugs. Xylazine can sometimes also be found in other drugs, including stimulants like cocaine and methamphetamine, and even pressed pills, which are counterfeit versions of drugs like Xanax or Percocet. There are xylazine test strips to test for the presence of xylazine, but because the drug supply is unregulated, there is no way to know how much xylazine is present. When xylazine is mixed with opioids, responding to an overdose can look a little different. Let's go over what you need to know to act quickly and safely in an emergency. Xylazine is often mixed with opioids, and the combined effects of xylazine and opioids can increase the risk of an opioid overdose. Signs of an opioid overdose, with or without the presence of xylazine, include not breathing, making gurgling sounds, or taking slow, gasping breaths, blue-tinged or pale lips, and loss of consciousness, inability to wake up. Xylazine does not respond to naloxone, but because we cannot know what mix of substances someone has taken, it is always important to use naloxone when responding to someone with any signs of overdose. If you suspect a possible opioid overdose, try to wake the person and check to see if they are breathing. If you believe they are overdosing, call 911 and administer naloxone. If a person is able to refuse the administration of naloxone, they are not experiencing an overdose. It is important to remember that the goal of naloxone is to restore breathing. A person may start breathing again after naloxone has been administered, but remain sedated due to xylazine. Once they are breathing, additional naloxone is not needed, even if they remain unconscious. Move the person into a recovery, side-lying position, remain with them, and wait for paramedics. All staff should be trained in overdose response. Finally, let's talk about one of the most visible effects of xylazine use: wounds. This section covers how to care for them and what steps can help promote healing. Xylazine-related wounds are complex and often appear visually concerning. The wounds can appear black due to tissue death, and they can have an odor. Xylazine wounds can heal, and they respond to consistent, quality wound care. Seek medical care for xylazine wounds, especially if you are concerned about infection. Do: wash hands with soap and water. Use clean gloves for wound care. Wash wounds with gentle soap and water, or rinse with clean water or saline. Keep wounds covered with a clean, dry dressing, preferably one that will not stick to the wound, and seek medical care and support for ongoing wound care. Don't: leave the wound uncovered or open to air, pick at the wound, or use harsh cleansers like bleach, alcohol, or peroxide. Avoid injecting into wounds if possible. It is important for everyone to know that xylazine can be an additive in the drug supply. People should know the signs of use and potential impact of xylazine. People can look out for themselves by using xylazine test strips, seeking help for withdrawal and wounds, and accessing treatment if they want to stop using. Everyone should be trained in how to properly respond to someone who may be experiencing an overdose.